Hi everyone and welcome back. It's Vicky here and today I'm featuring foiling plates from the Christmas Foiled Basics collection by Yannas Makoula. This is a wonderful collection that I have been using throughout the week and I think that Yana really nailed it. I am going to use today this set. This is the Christmas sentiments that give you plates with sentiments in lovely fonts, and they also give you the dies. If you take a close-up look here, you will see that you get all the numbers and one kind of locks next to each other. So you can easily create a rows of numbers like 2021 for the next year, and you know that they are perfectly aligned. And this is the case with another sentiment. This is the word from. I'm trying to pick it out from my magnet. Now this has three little legs underneath and it locks with other matching sentiments. So for example, you can have from all of us and you can see that it kind of locks there, so you know that they are perfectly spaced and aligned. I find this really clever, having those plates locking one in another, because it really makes my life easy and I know that my sentiments are nicely aligned. Now this is the Christmas Foliage Circle Border. This is absolutely gorgeous. I really love it. It gives you a little poinsettias and leaves and everything you need to create a little wreath of Christmas, as well as this circle tie. The border underneath fits inside and you also get a circle that creates a lovely foiled border. Now I'm going to use both of them here, and there is a similar set that gives you the same design but with flowers, so you can use it throughout the year. This is specifically for Christmas. Today I'm going to use both of these sets and create a couple of Christmas cards. Just because I love traditional colors and Christmas cards, one of them is going to be with reds, golds and greens. So here I'm going to use the gold foil. I'm picking one of the sentiments, trying to decide which is going to use. And of course it fits inside the circle. So this is going to create a lovely foiled circle with a sentiment inside. And I always like to use a little bit of washi tape to keep everything together, so nothing is going to move on me as I take out the platform. Now, through my stash, I found this circle die, and this is pretty much the same size as the plate. So I'm going to use that and draw a line all around the circle. And look how I'm checking that the foliage is going to fit all around. So I'm going to draw a circle. This is not going to show at all. This is just as a guide on where I need to do the foiling. So here I'm going to place next to that line of circle my plate. I'm going to anchor it with a washi tape and then I can add some foil underneath. So I kind of created a hinge. This way I know exactly where I need that foiled. And I need to repeat that process three times all around the circle to make sure that I have a complete wreath. The red cardstock I'm working on is slightly smaller than the standard card, so it's going to leave a little border at the end. Now I'm going to create everything else that I need foiled for my card. I have a little piece of green cardstock and I'm going to pick a few of the leaves. Again, I'm going to use my gold foil. I'm going to place on top everything I need from the little leaves, and notice that you don't only get the detail for foiling, but you also get the ties to cut them out. Again, I will use my washi tape to make sure that nothing is going to move. And now I'm ready to do the foiling. So you can see here I have my sentiment, my leaves. This is a little poinsettia from the same set, and I do have an extra sentiment here with gold foil, which I'm not going to use at the end. Now I'm going to place the plates on top, press that button, and I'm waiting for that light to stop blinking. Then I know that everything is nice and warm. I'm going to run it through my die cutting machine a couple of times in slow motion. This is going to ensure that I will end up having a lovely foiled detail. And I'm going to peel it off so you can see the results. So here is the sentiment that I didn't end up using, but I can always use it on another Christmas card. Here is my poinsettia. I'm going to peel off the main sentiment and look how gorgeous this looks. I absolutely love this one. And here are the leaves. In the meantime, my red cardstock is in the machine, so it's getting ready to add that foliage around the circle. And now let's take a look at the results. I did end up making a new poinsettia. I thought I wanted more than one, but I'm not going to use it. And here is the lovely wreath. I repeated the same process two more times, and here is the complete wreath. Super shiny, and I think it looks stunning. Now, if you have any overfoiling, you can use a sand eraser, and this is going to fix any problems like that. Now, from my stash, I found the circle die that fits perfectly around that sentiment with the ring. I'm also going to use the matching dies for the leaves. I'm going to cut out the poinsettia. And with the magic of video editing, I have all the pieces ready here, so it's time to put my card together. I have a 4.25 by 5.5 white card base. I'm going to stick on top my red panel using glue at the back. For the circle, I want to have some dimension, so I'm going to use some foam tape there. And you can leave it as it is. I think this card looks beautiful. However, I'm going to embellish it a little bit more with all the leaves and the poinsettia that I have. For the poinsettia, I'm going with a little foam tape at the back. And then I'm going to tuck underneath the leaves, just to create a little Christmas cluster there. Of all the cards that I make throughout the year, my favorite is to create cards for Christmas. And if you ask me, foiling is a perfect match for Christmas cards. They give that extra shine and sparkle that you need. Plus, there is something special about foiled cards. They make the card look really professional. So here are some close-up photos on the first card for today. That golden wreath around the sentiment, I think, is just stunning. And I did finish off the poinsettia by adding a white gem on top. For my next card, I'm going to use the Glimmer Gift Border, which I think is super cute. You can use it in so many different color combos. I'm going for a non-traditional color scheme for this card, and I'm working on light blue cardstock, and I will be working with this lovely teal foil that matches the color of my cardstock. Just like I did for the previous card, I'm going to repeat the same design and create a little circle with the sentiment inside. This time my sentiment says Season's Greetings, again using the same teal foil. And look how lovely it looks. Now I have another set of plates, and this is also designed by Yana. This is called Christmas Organic Foliage. It gives you lots and lots of leaves and other stuff that you can create little clusters. And in comparison to the other one that I used for the first card, you can see that they are bigger. So you can choose whatever you want. Now I'm going to use the bigger of the leaves from here. I'm going to use the plate as well as the matching die. And first I'm going to do some inking. So here I'm using Distress Oxide ink in a slightly darker color than my card base. You can start, of course, with a white card base and just combine lighter colors, but I decided that this was the easiest way. So as you can see, I'm adding ink of a darker blue only at the edges. This way the center is going to look as if it is glowing. Now look how dull the foiling becomes. Don't worry at all about that. The Distress Oxide ink sits on top of foiling. It doesn't discolor it at all. All you have to do is to just use a clean cloth or a paper towel, and you can have the shine back. Now I want to darken up the edges even more, and by adding that black soot only at the very edge, it's going to make it look as if the center is glowing even more. I am really happy with the background, and probably out of the two cards for today, this is my favorite. I absolutely love this background. Let me know in the comments below which one is your favorite too. And of course, don't forget to go back with your cloth and remove any excess ink that stays on top of foiling. Using the same foam roll, I did create those two leaves, as well as a little poinsettia on white cardstock. And I did use the matching dies to cut all those shapes. I also used the dies of the leaves to cut out two leaves out of vellum. I'm going to use those to add a little bit more bulk and make that embellishment fuller. So again, I'm inking up the edges just to have everything match with the background. Again, I have foam tape at the back of my circle. This is going to go at the center of my panel. For both these cards, I'm using the exact same design. Now, you can have leaves all around and embellish the sentiment like that. However, since I'm staying with the same design, I'm going to do just what I did with the first card. So you can see that the same design can have completely different looks. I'm going to create a little cluster there with the leaves. And at the center, I'm going to use the poinsettia, this time in white. To finish off my card, I'm going to add a little blue gem at the center of my poinsettia. I think it matches nicely with the rest of the blues for a monochromatic card with lots of shine. Now, all I have to do is to stick this panel on top of a standard card that's 4.25 by 5.5. And here are some close-up photos on the last card for today. Don't forget, just like always, you will find links to everything I used down below in the description area. Thank you all so much for spending some time with me today. I hope that you had fun, that you got inspired, and I'll see you all next time.